After another week in which questions about his campaign's ties to Russia became more pointed, Donald Trump did what he's done often when backed into a corner, go on the attack. But his target today has many stunned. In a series of early morning tweets, Trump accused former President Barack Obama of spying on him, tweeting that Obama had my wires tapped in Trump Tower just before the victory. Nothing found. This is McCarthyism. And this, how low has President Obama gone to tap my phones during the very sacred election process? This is Nixon Watergate. Bad or sick guy. What triggered the tweet storm is an open question. Was it the controversy surrounding Attorney General Jeff Sessions after it was revealed that he failed to disclose two meetings with the Russian ambassador? Or could it have been this article posted last night from the right-wing website Breitbart, which outlines a conservative radio host theory on how the Obama administration has attempted to undermine Trump? Lindsey Graham, a frequent Trump critic, says while the charges against Obama are troubling, he's most concerned about another possibility.
I would be very worried if, in fact, the Obama administration was able to obtain a warrant lawfully about Trump campaign activity with foreign governments.
An FBI investigation has already reported on Russian meddling in the U.S. election, and it's widely known it's investigating alleged contacts between some of Trump's team and Russian officials during the campaign. Media reports going back to November suggest a warrant had been issued for a computer server at Trump Tower, but not specifically targeting Trump. Known as a FISA warrant, it would have been issued by a judge in a secret hearing.
The FISA court has to be presented information in which an American citizen is either working with a foreign intelligence agency or is a national security threat to the United States.
Former intelligence officer Malcolm Nance has written a book on Russia's hacking of the U.S. election. He says Trump's tweets may have inadvertently confirmed that those warrants exist.
There is information out there which is going to corner him in relation to Russia and the hacking, and he doesn't know the source, and now he is flailing.
Trump has presented no evidence to back up his claim. President Obama's spokesman responded with this statement. A cardinal rule of the Obama administration was that no White House official ever interfered with any independent investigation led by the Department of Justice. The statement went on to say that as part of that practice, neither President Obama nor White House officials ever ordered surveillance of a U.S. citizen, and any suggestion otherwise, the statement says, would be simply false. Stephen D'Souza, CBC News, New York.
That sentiment is being echoed by other Republican colleagues, including Senator Ben Sasse of Nebraska, who put out a statement a little while ago saying that the public needs more information about the president's allegations. He says that if there was wiretapping, it was either with or without a warrant from a special court known as a FISA court. If it was without that warrant, then the president needs to explain what kind of wiretap this was and how he knows about it. And if it was with this legal court order, he says the president should ask that the application for surveillance be made public to everyone, or at the very least to the U.S. Senate. He went on to say, we're in the midst of a civilization warping crisis of trust, and the president's allegations to date demand the thorough and dispassionate attention of serious patriots. And it's worth restating here, Pamela, just what Shimon was saying, and that is that former senior officials are saying that the idea that then-candidate Trump's phones were wiretapped is just wrong. One other official said it was just nonsense.